Hey, Gold Digger, Kimberly Olson here, back for another episode of Hashtag Get Lit, where we crush your business in less than 10 minutes. For today's episode, I'm super excited to do a Trello training. As you know, I believe hashtag Trello is life, and there are so many amazing tools and things that you can do with it that people don't understand. But when it comes to productivity and organization, using tools like Trello is absolutely key. So today we're going to dive into how to use Trello cards and sync them up to your Google Calendar. Stay tuned. Tutorial, we're actually going to work off this demo board I made so you can see exactly how this is going to work. So you need Trello. You can build out all of the Trello that you want with free version of Trello. So just get Trello if you don't have it. And then what you're going to do is you are going to set up your Trello board so that way we can start planning some content and syncing it to our Google Calendar. One of the things I've noticed is that when people attempt to start planning, they will get it going and then they just sort of stop doing it. And in order for it to make it work for you, you've got to get it on your calendar. When we get things on our calendar, it's scheduled. It's, you know, you can involve other people if you have a VA or team members, and it's more real to you. If it's an appointment, it's on your calendar. Plus it stays top of mind because you're going to see it. I use Google Calendar. I highly recommend it. There's an app as well. You can share your calendar with others. You can also let others work on it. You can invite others to the calendar appointments. It's pretty robust and amazing, okay? And it syncs with Trello. So for this example, I just put on here Facebook Lives and Challenges. So how this will work is whatever you put here for the title, that is what's going to show up on your calendar. We're going to dictate the date inside of the card with a due date. But for now, I want you to keep in mind, if this was on your calendar, what would you want it to read so you know what it meant? So let's say you go live at 1 o'clock Central every Monday on your business page, such as I do, then when you see that on your calendar at 1 o'clock, what should it say so you know? Well, for me, I want to make sure I have the topic in there. And whatever you put in here, when you click it on your calendar, it's going to open up this Trello card. So you could even put your notes in here. I mean, the sky's the limit. You know what I'm saying? So let's just say this is what we're going to start with. We're going to do a Facebook Live in the group that you have, and it's how to time block like a boss. Okay, we've got our title. Great. Now, how do we get it on the calendar? So what you're going to do is you're going to click dates. And then let's say I'm going to do something really far out, so it's a little easier to look at my calendar. So we're going to do September. Let's do September 7th. I don't have a lot going on that day. And let me make sure everything looks okay on here. September 7th. Now, if we want to set date and time, which we will, we're going to say 1 o'clock. No, we'll do 1 o'clock. And then you can tell it when to set the due date at time of due date. Makes sense because we want it to be on there for that day. Okay, we're going to save it. So now you're like, okay, great. Now, how does this actually sync up to my calendar? What you're actually going to do is go over to power-ups and you're going to add a power-up. Okay. And then you're just going to search calendar. Add the calendar power-up. Pretty awesome, right? Great. That's all you got to do. Click calendar. Okay. Now, when you click the calendar power-up that has just appeared on this actual board, what you want to do is you just want to make sure that the sync button is displayed. Okay. So click settings and you're going to click enable sync. Okay. So we went to the power ups, we added the calendar, we clicked on the calendar, it brought us here. And then we're actually also going to click the gear button and we're going to click enable sync. When you do that, you are basically sync this Trello board's calendar with your personal calendar. Okay. So you could just copy this right here, and then we're going to put this inside of your Google Calendar, okay? At any time, because I played around with this and I didn't like how it imported when I first did it, I just disabled the sync and it pulled the Trello cards off my Google Calendar. But for this one, we are going to, we're going to just keep it as it is here, okay? The other thing I want to note is if you look on here, because we did September, you're not seeing it. But you can have it where it shows everything that you put is going to show up on here. So if you have all your Facebook Lives planned out, I also had a column for challenges in your Facebook group for your team or for your own brand. All of that will show up in here if you click calendar. You can also click calendar again, and it's going to take you back to this view on here as well. Okay. So let's take a look at how we can actually sync this now into our Google Calendar as well. All right, so hopefully you can't see anything too personal here, but if you can, just delete it from your memory. All right, so what you're going to do is you're going to go to your calendar. So we're in Google Calendar right now, and best to do this from desktop. And then I'm going to go to my calendar, which is Kimberly Olson, and I'm going to click Settings and Sharing. Over here on the left, you're going to click Add Calendar. Remember that URL we had from Trello? From the URL, you're going to click here, drop the URL in here, and then you add the calendar. So it can take a second. Obviously, see it says fetching data. I also have a little workaround for if it's not syncing up new events, there's some troubleshooting that you can see. And did you guys just see that pop out on real time? Here it is. This is the Facebook Live in the group had a time block. When you click it, here is the Trello card. I mean, drop the mic, right? So imagine you have something collaborative you're doing, whether it's working with your team to launch a challenge, or maybe you're working with a VA. You can put the checklist together in Trello. You can have the to-do list. You can have who's involved, important attachments. All that can be on the Trello card. But then on our calendars here, so we, because what happens is you plan everything and then it's out of sight, out of mind. We need a place for it in real time. Okay. So if you click this, it's actually going to open up my Trello board where we just were, and it's going to open up that card. And as you can see, there's that September at 1 o'clock central, which is on there, which is so, so awesome. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get you that workaround right now and show you how to find that as well. All right, so now I would like to show you there's another power up that you can add. Just click power ups that you can add, add power ups, where this one is actually a workaround that someone created, which is kind of cool, that will real time calendar sync between Trello and your calendar. So if you click it and just click add. And there's different, you know, some people have, you know, different opinions on it. I think it's just fine. Okay. So we've got that in there, the Chronify, and then, by adding that, click settings, and then you're actually just going to, edit the power up settings, which you do when you do that, it's going to get your permission to access the content on the Trello board, access your Google Calendar. So you need to be okay with that. After you go through where it says edit power up settings through the Chronify, you know, power up, then it will actually sync up. It's going to take a minute, but it's going to sync up your Trello board to your Google Calendar. And anytime there is a date on your Trello board, like I showed you, put that due date, it's going to pull those cards over. The one thing I will say is the default settings on Chronify is, here, let me just stop the share because that's distracting. The Chronify default settings will be, I think, like 10-minute appointment slots. I went in there when I was looking at it, and one of them, it allowed you to adjust it. So I adjusted mine to 30 minutes. I just thought that looked a little weird on the calendar entry. So just one little hack there. You can edit the settings in there. So some of this stuff, yeah, it takes a minute to like figure it out. And you're going to have to watch what I did and pause it. But once you have it set up, you have to think about how much time it's going to save you. What we have to do is we have to stop going around and looking for things and where did I put that and having our information all over the place. We need our applications to communicate to each other, especially when we start bringing other people into the mix or we're starting to tackle this whole thing of organization, productivity, putting systems in place. That's really important to start remembering. In order to speed up, you do need to slow down first. And we are, you know, up against this misconception that it's easier just to do it the way you've been doing it. How's that serving you? How's that working for you? And is that duplicatable? If you were sick, could you hand over your business to a VA to keep it up and running or your team? And if not, then you've got some work to do. Okay. So I'm really excited for you to implement this into your business, and it's going to help you be more efficient for sure. If this was helpful, I would love if you subscribe to this YouTube channel, browse my other topics. I've got so many playlists and awesome tools for you, and subscribe, click the like button, depending on where you're watching this, and take a screenshot and let's create a discussion question. Throw this in your stories, tag me at the Gold Digger Girl, and just say, just learned about how to use Trello with my Google Calendar. What about you? Do you use Trello for business? And I think that could be a really great conversation to have with those that interact with your story. Thank you for watching so much. Until next time, get lit in your business and set your soul on fire. We'll see you soon.